for dancers. So this is a squat that's going to exercise the piriformis, which is basically the muscle that's under the bottom and connects the hamstring and the head of the femur to the hip itself. So you're going to pull back so that the standing leg is at a 90 degree angle. So you're not way over here like you would be in a grand prix. You're sort of pulled back. And you're going to lift this leg up off the ground. And again, you're sitting back in the heel so that most of the weight is in the seat of the standing leg. And you're going to do a very simple squat and extend the leg and come up. It's very important that the knee does not go over the toe and that you don't go all the way down, because now you're going to be locking into the quads as you stand up. Abdominal exercise I've ever done in my entire life. It's a full body crunch and you can combine it with a plank and push up. So I'm going to sit and put my legs in the loops and cross one leg over the other so I can switch to my knees. So I call this a piriformis plie. You're gonna have one leg in the stirrup, and you can use a kettlebell here if you have one. Otherwise, I like to use opposite arm as leg out to the side and put the other one straight in front and keep the head down to the ground. I'm in a plie position, and at no point is the knee gonna go so far over the toe that I lose my balance. So if it is going significantly far over the toe, you're actually gonna wanna be a little bit farther away from the band. So we're gonna be here, we're gonna just do a demi-plie, and you're gonna curl the spine, and then you're gonna straighten up. And demi-plie, curl, and straighten up. And you're gonna feel this in the seat of the standing leg and the piriformis, and a little bit in the minimus as well. And it's very important that in this position, you're almost trying to tuck the tailbone under. It's not going to tuck, there's no way you can tuck it. If you start to feel pressure on the knee, let up on the tucking. But even in this position without any tucking, I'm still feeling a significant amount in my seat. And straighten up. It's also important that you stay in parallel for this position. Although you can feel it turned out, you're gonna get more out of it if you're parallel. This one's for the triceps. It's very important that you keep the shoulders grounded and that you keep the legs firmly attached to the ground and that you don't let your knees go in and out. You're going to extend and then you're going to pull the elbows out to the side as you come up. Exercise. This is called a plank plie, and you can do it facing the ground in plank position, or you can do it from the back. So I'll show you both versions. So you're going to get yourself in a plank position in parallel, flexing the feet, and you're going going to demi-plie, turn the knobs into first position at the same time, and then extend and rotate back. Show you today is a simple pike, which is not simple, and I don't recommend doing it unless you either A, have a spotter, or B, have somebody catch you in case you fall on your head, or you've been doing it for a couple years. Best conditioning ever. So good for you.